How did it feel? How did it go for you?
It seemed to go well. It's a bit of a blur, actually, the press night. You know, we got all the lines right, I think, and the exploding cigar went off, I think.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it felt great, actually. It felt like a lot of energy, and I really enjoyed it, which is unusual for a press night, but I actually enjoyed it. It was good.
For anyone who wasn't fortunate enough to be here, can we start by just a quick synopsis? What is the Hot House all about?
It's basically about, it's in a kind of state-run institution. We're never quite clear exactly what happens in this place. It's described as a convalescent home, and a rest home, a sanatorium. It's clearly actually about a group of maniacal leaders in an office who effectively torture political dissidents. So it sounds incredibly dark and depressing. But what's bizarre about it is that it's got this kind of surprising kind of satirical edge. It's amazingly funny. And I think Pinter absolutely wanted it, speaking to Pinter's widow, Lady Antonia, he absolutely wanted it to be as funny as it possibly could be. As light as it becomes, the lighter it becomes, the more disturbing it is. And I think with this cast, they absolutely pull that off.
John, where do you fit into this hysterical and slightly dark story? Can you tell us a little bit about your character?
Gibbs is when the play opens, he's the second in command, and to Mr. Root, who runs the institution. But it's sort of, he's like the through line of action. You follow him all the way through the play, and he's still there at the end, and a lot of them aren't. Not giving it away, I hope. But yeah, he's a sort of Machiavellian character with a lot of topspin.
He keeps it well concealed.
And you see little glimpses of it, especially in one scene, you see the real him. And yeah, you know, it's a fantastic character to play.
We talked a little bit about the mercurial cast. You're working with, obviously, the magnificent Simon Russell Beale, a legend of the West End. What makes him such a very, very special performer?
Well, he's one of the finest stage actors of this generation, without a shadow of a doubt, proven time and time again. And when I heard he was doing this, it was just a no-brainer. You know, it was Jamie and Simon Russell Beale, Pinter in the West End. It was like Christmas. So I get to stand on stage and watch Simon Russell Beale perform a masterclass every single night, and it's a joy. It's an absolute pleasure. It really is.
Obviously, tonight's a fantastic advert for the merits of the West End. I mean, what do you think makes it so very special, and why is it important for people to continue to support it?
I think there are amazing spaces, and I think we have created something very different at Trafalgar Studios with our Trafalgar Transform season. You know, we've completely transformed the entire space by raising the stage by 2 meters, surging out into the auditorium by 4 meters. So it's got a particular kind of relationship with the audience that is quite unique, I think. It's quite idiosyncratic and very special. But we have the finest actors in the world in this country, and I'm very, very lucky to have 7 of the very, very best in one cast. I mean, they are literally at the top of their game. And John is able to kind of turn on a sixpence to be incredibly light, incredibly funny in one moment, and unbelievably dark in the next, and absolutely is able to kind of plummet into the depths and kind of keep a smile on his face at the same time. I don't know quite how he does it, and juggles both facets of the character with dexterity. And the same is true of Simon and Indira and Clive and Chris and John Heffernan and Harry Melling. It's a real ensemble piece, and that's what's so thrilling about it, actually.
Do you have a message to fans, particularly, I guess, about this production and why they should be rushing out to buy their ticket for The Hot House?
Well, what Jamie's done to this theatre is quite incredible, first of all, I have to say that. I performed here in 2008, I think it was, a play called Elling. And it was a very difficult place to come and perform on. It was a huge bank of seats, and it was quite daunting, and it wasn't very welcoming. And when I walked in to see what he'd done to it, I mean, it blew my mind. It's actually a proper theatre now, I think, and such an incredible space to perform in. And so, you know, Trafalgar Transformed is transformed. And I would say if you haven't been there, then you should go there. And not only for that, but because we're doing a Harold Pinter play. And Harold Pinter is one of the greatest writers that has ever walked the earth. And Jamie Lloyd is one of the greatest directors that has ever walked the earth. And he's got one of the greatest casts I've ever been involved with. So, and on top of all that, it's hilarious. Mm-hmm. And Simon Russell Beale, like I said, delivers a masterclass. So you shouldn't miss it.
Congratulations, first of all, on tonight. A fantastic opening night. I guess the first question for fans who weren't lucky enough to be here, tell us a little bit about your character and what excited you about this production.
Well, my character is a bit of a monster, to be honest. And he runs an institution, which you don't know what it does precisely, but it seems to do something about political prisoners, I think, probably. Anyway, it's a very unpleasant man, actually. So he is the head of this institution.
You're working with a fantastic cast, the likes of John Sim and Dave. I mean, can you talk a little bit about working with him and the rest of the gang?
Well, they're amazing. I mean, it's very, very rare to have such a hugely, what we call luxury casting in the business, isn't it? That sort of, you know, Clive Rowe doing one scene. I mean, Clive Rowe is one of the big, big musical stars of British theatre. And John, of course, with The Village and his other TV stuff is, you know, very, very high profile indeed. I mean, they're amazing. They've been amazing. I think what Jamie's done is to accept the fact that this is a very early Pinter and it's structured like a farce, and he's gone for it. I mean, the famous Pinter pause, we don't do at all, I don't think. I mean, I think it just sort of goes straight through. So we've got rid of all the pauses and all the portentousness, I suppose. I've already had a beer, so... I can't say portentousness very well. We've sort of got rid of all that and tried to sort of shake the cobwebs off this very early play that he wrote. So,
wonderful productions, part of the Trafalgar Transform season. Transforming literally one of our finest theatre venues. What do you think that's giving audiences that process?
Well, geographically, the theatre's been completely changed so that the access of the audience to the stage is much more acute. But also the what Jamie and Sutra have done, the designer, is make it very, dirty and rough. And I think it's very exciting what they've done with that space.
I want to congratulate you on The Hollow Crown. I think, obviously, an absolutely beloved adaptation that really blew people away. Can you talk a little bit about that and working with, of course, the luminous young Tom Hiddleston?
Yeah, indeed. I saw him a couple of days ago, looking even more luminous than usual. He's
amazing. He always does. I don't know why.
I know he does, doesn't he? He sort of brushes up very well. Yes, him. Well, that, I mean, talking about cast for that, I mean, you don't often get a Shakespeare with Maxine Peake doing, you know, 20 Lines and Julie Walters and Jeremy Irons. And Tom was extraordinary. I mean, my character had the closest relationship with Tom than with anybody. And he's the most amazing creature. And he's developing all the time. That sounds terribly patronizing, doesn't it? But I feel like an elder statesman. He is developing all the time. And, great actor.
Why do you think it's important for people to continue to support theatre?
Because it is simply unpredictable. And I'm going to tell you something. I dried last night, which means I forgot my lines. It's never happened to me before, but I had to be prompted, which has never happened to me before. And somebody said to me, well, that's the point about live theatre, isn't it? So that's it, really. You can see the flesh and blood, you can see the sweat, and you can see the work and smell the actors.
It's always very exciting an opening night. You know, you're working from beginning of rehearsals, which could be 4 to 6 weeks. It was 4 weeks on this, to this specific moment and the rest of the run. But it was such a wonderful audience tonight. Very, very, very generous and very, very warm. Yeah, it's very exciting.
For people who weren't lucky enough to be here tonight, can you tell us a little bit about where you fit into the production?
Okay, my name's Tub, and I play, I play with the orderly, who looks after the hothouse. I have a kind of a small appearance in the second act, and I'm kind of get on with everybody in the building, so I'm kind of non-threatening is the best way to describe me.
it's an astonishing cast, the likes of Simon Russell Beale, John. I mean, can you talk a little bit about working with some of our finest West End performers?
Well, it's one of those things where, you know, I've been in the business quite a long time now, believe it or not. And sometimes you walk into a rehearsal space and you know that not only are you going to have a great time and have a lot of respect from the people that you're working with, but you're going to learn and learn and learn. And the amount of talent, I was saying, sat next to John Sim in the wings this very evening, and I said one of the joys of it is this, that across the board it's an incredible company and an incredible group of actors, and you never stop learning, and you only have to be in a room with Simon Russell Beale and your kind of game goes up and up and up and up.
The Trafalgar Transform season has literally transformed one of our best theatres. Can you talk a little bit about that and what you think it's giving audiences?
Well, I did a show called Simply Heavenly here a couple of years ago, and I thought it was quite an extraordinary space then. But what they've managed to do by raising the floor up about four, I think it's like 4 to 6 rows that they've done it, they've managed to make it an even more intimate space. And that huge kind of, if people have been there, there's like a kind of a steep banking of seats, and they've managed to make the back of the auditorium as intimate as the front of the auditorium. And with this, they've got it almost in a kind of a parade stage setting. We've got audience on both sides, so the intimacy is even closer, and it's rare to have that amount of seating in a theatre space and that intimacy at the same time, so it's quite exciting for an actor.
For young fans who would love to follow in your footsteps and be part of the West End, can you tell us what life in the West End's really like, and what advice, if any, you'd give them for getting there?
Life in the West End can be as it can be as rewarding and as cruel as any job that you will do anywhere. The only thing that I would say to anybody coming into it, I'm not trying to put a downer on it, but the only thing that you can do is work, work, work. Just get yourself out there, get yourself seen, work, and have respect for the people around you, because you learn your trade from your peers. As I am doing after 20 odd years, I'm still learning from my peers, and that learning curve will never stop for you. And as long as you're ready for that, and as long as you're ready to put yourself out there, especially as a young and new actor, and say, I want to be part of this, I want to be part of this creative force, which is the West End, and I want to be able to give my performance to not just the people who are coming to see it, but the generations that will follow, and I want to pass on my knowledge and experience to those people, then you're on the right track.
If anyone wants to come and see a masterclass in West End acting, where can they come? Where are you on at? Where can we get ticket information from?
We're on at the Trafalgar Studios. I'm sure you can get tickets, ticket information online. And the Trafalgar Studios, quite luckily, is right next to Trafalgar Square.